Hi, I'm Kate Georgie from Aaron Fox from the International Trade Group, and this is Fox Chat number three. I have with me my colleague, Sylvia Costello from sunny California. Hello, Sylvia.
Hello, Kate. How are you?
I am well, thank you. We are both working remotely, and we're talking about something on Fox Chat 3 that is quite serious today. We're talking about masks and personal protective equipment. This is equipment that has, of a recent date, been subjected to export controls from really all around the world. And so Sylvia has been working on a very important project. Sylvia, you want to tell us a little bit about the project?
Yes, thank you, Kay. We know that hospitals and other medical providers are short on masks and other personal protective equipment at the moment. And so we created a reference chart for hospitals to be able to refer to determine what the export control restrictions are on various personal protective equipment.
So, for example, if you're working in a hospital in New York City, and you've discovered that you have a source in Hong Kong that can send you masks, and you wonder whether there are any export restrictions, you can go to our chart and figure out if Hong Kong allows masks to be exported to the United States or whether you have to get an export license to do that.
And the answer to your question, Kay, is that for Hong Kong, you don't need an export license.
But that's not true for a whole bunch of other countries, as our chart shows. How many countries right now, Sylvia, are requiring export licenses or actually just flat out prohibiting the export of masks and other PPE?
Well, actually, we reviewed a total of 46 countries and their export restrictions. A number of those countries do have restrictions on exports of personal protective equipment. To name just a few, the European Union has a ban on exports, as does Bahrain, India, Egypt, Indonesia, Malaysia, Russia, to name just a few. But going back to your other question, Kay, there are actually some countries that do not have export restrictions, and those are China, Hong Kong, Japan, and New Zealand. So we have a total of four countries that do not have export restrictions. We reviewed 46 countries, so the other 42 do have export restrictions.
So that's quite a large number of countries currently imposing export restrictions. One of the countries that really is not still, that Sylvia didn't mention because we're in it, is the United States currently does not have any export control restrictions, provided the masks and other PPE are not actually called out on the Commerce Control List as a dual-use controlled item. They don't require a license except to embargoed countries or to restricted parties. Now, that actually could be changing any day now. There has been a lot of rumblings in the U.S. government about imposing restrictions on masks and other PPE. So that's something you should stay tuned to. Our chart actually includes a line on the United States with some warnings, including links to a recent letter that went from Congress to the White House on this very same subject. So where can we find this chart, Sylvia?
Well, we're flashing the link to the chart here on our Fox Chat, so you can click on the link and get to the chart. The chart also provides information about local counsel, whom you can contact if you have questions about whether or not your product is covered or whether or not it requires a license.
So yes, we'll put the link also in our posting on LinkedIn. So there's LinkedIn has the chart. It will be kept up to date as best as we can. Just keep in mind, the countries are changing constantly and the controls are changing constantly. So in any case, you should always consult your local counsel to make sure that the information is 100% up to date because it's changing. Also, we do have a chart on importing personal protective equipment, a guidance on how to import personal protective equipment into the United States, and we'll flash that link up on the screen as well. So all in all, we're just hoping that our chart and these guidances help hospitals and medical professionals get the personal protective equipment they need so that they can stay safe and so that their patients can stay safe. So that's about all we have for Fox Chat for today. We really appreciate it, and we will do our best to keep our PPE charts up to date. And we hope you all stay safe. Take care.
Bye.